Hello, Phil here from Wings of Pegasus, and welcome to another analysis video. On the agenda tonight, we have T-Bone Walker, and this is coming all the way back from 1966, and it's for the BBC, BBC TV. So that's a station here in England, but let's get T-Bone up on screen and see how he gets on.
Woman, you must be crazy. You don't know what you want to do. Woman, you must be crazy. You don't know what you want to do. Guess where could you be going, baby? After all I've done for you. I'm in love with a woman.
I'm just going to jump in here because I want to draw attention to the fact, a lot of people will know this already, but if you don't, the similarity and the fact that T-Bone Walker was the main inspiration, or at least one of two, of Chuck Berry, who I did a video on the other night, and you can really see some of the lines that T-Bone plays that Chuck Berry has absolutely taken on, and the whole style as well. So many guitarists were influenced by this guy and took on his playing technique. B.B. King as well, another giant of the blues, absolutely influenced by T-Bone Walker. He was the guy that actually inspired B.B. to just buy a guitar in the first place. T-Bone used to play with his teeth as well. That's something that Jimi Hendrix then took on, having seen T-Bone, and Hendrix got a lot of coverage for doing that. Steve Miller as well said that T-Bone showed him how to play guitar behind his back. So there's that as well. And it's interesting here actually, because T-Bone's guitar, I think it's the Gibson ES5 that he's playing. I'll have to watch the video again, just make sure I got that right. But it's such a big body guitar. When he goes into his lead, he actually puts that guitar up, you know, flips it forward. You could see. Let's get into a little bit more of this performance.
But she's not in love with me. I'm in love with a woman. But she's not in love with me. Yes, I love the woman because she's my old time used to be.
I'm just going to be coming in here because another thing that flies under the radar with these great blues players is the vocals. The fact that their voice is so great, and such a great bluesy voice T-Bone Walker had. And another thing about B.B. King, I mentioned on the video that I did with B.B., the fact that his vocals are just so strong. You get really attracted into the technique and the feel and the groove that they lay down on the fretboard, and you get some players who just play guitar and that's it. Whereas when you start adding vocals into the mix as well, I always say it doubles the difficulty because it now gives you two voices. You can now go to the guitar, it's going to tell a story, and then you can tell a story with your vocals as well. So don't understate the importance of laying down a great vocal as well as laying down some excellent lead guitar lines. And I've just cued it forward a little bit just to hear a bit more of the guitar and the singing that I was just mentioning, but I'm not going to have time to watch this whole video. I'm going to put the link in the description below so you guys can check out the whole video if you want to, but let's just watch a little bit more.
Yes, I love my woman because she's my old time used to be.
I'm just gonna jump in here. I don't want this video to go on for too long, but this is one of those videos that you just want to hear a little bit more and then a little bit more. And we've got a really cool swing blues going on here. And you could see that, you know, B.B. King, T-Bone as well, Jimi Hendrix later on, they all have this stretch, this handspan just all over the fretboard that just seems so easy for them to make what would be actually to a normal person a really big stretch, especially in blues progressions, the fact that often you're going to be over five frets stretching first finger, little finger in order to get that rhythm going. So yeah, they've all got that hand that is just destined to play guitar. And T-Bone's one of those guys, at the age of 10, he dropped out of school, but then by the age of 15, he was a professional performer. So he got his playing up to the professional level within 5 years of dropping out of school. So really impressive. T-Bone's stepfather taught him banjo and mandolin, ukulele, piano, a violin as well. So T-Bone absolutely had that music through to his core. He was just born to do music, born to play the guitar, but also to play all those other instruments. So as a musician, by the age of 15, obviously he had had so much exposure to so many different instruments that he had a great appreciation of music and therefore could start working professionally as a musician, as a performer. And after his death, T-Bone was inducted into the Blues Hall of Fame, and that was in 1980. And then in 1987, he was then inducted into the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame as well. But this one is certainly a really interesting watch, especially after the analysis of Chuck Berry and B.B. King. It's great to see T-Bone, the fact that he laid the foundation for so many future generations of great blues players. But thank you so much for suggesting this video for me to take a look at in the first place. Keep those coming in the comments below. Let me know what you guys think. And if you like this video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe. And I'll see you guys at the next one. Rock!